Is this the greatest Stephen King
adaptation ever?
What's up? It's your boy Short Story Dude. Today on Phantom of the India Review, we're going to be talking about a little feature film. This one comes to us from writer-director John Lee Hancock, who brought us films like The Blind Side or The Little Things, which is a great Denzel Washington movie. The movie in discussion, Mr. Harrigan's Phone. That's another one of the plethora of short stories from Stephen King. This one comes from a collection of short stories from Stephen King entitled If It Bleeds, which was released in 2020. In 2003, Craig befriends a loner millionaire who goes by the name Mr. Harrington. Mr. Harrington kind of recruits him one day at a church service. He takes a liking to Craig and sees his reading skills are up to par and hires him for dirt cheap to come to his manor 3 times a week and read him stories. And it progresses over the years where the books that he started reading as a child, he is now comprehending more as a high schooler, which is cool because he's building this bond of knowledge and reading through Mr. Harrigan. And Mr. Harrigan thinks he's just doing it for the money out of sheer boredom. Mr. Harrigan's kind of jaded. So essentially the title, Mr. Harrigan's Phone, through the years of them bonding over books, Craig becomes a teenager and it is around the time that the first iPhone is introduced and he gets one and he sees the fascination of technology. And to pay Mr. Harrigan some appreciation, he buys him an iPhone in turn, where Mr. Harrigan gets kind of hooked with this. And then that's where there's this cool contrast between reading and texting, books and movies, the two types of media that intertwine in kind of a poetic way. Miss Harrigan becomes fascinated with his phone. He sees all the things that you can do on it, but then he in turn realizes all the issues that come with cell phones and social media. And this is a time when the iPhone is first introduced, so it's almost like him foreshadowing is what to happen with social media. And then Craig, on the other hand, reading all these books, is finding the power in the past and how it can round him to be a full-fledged adult, even though he's learning from words before. And Mr. Harrigan makes a small comment saying that, you know, social media is whatever, but books are eternal. And you could argue the same thing with social media at the point that we're getting. So it's almost like a dichotomy between one generation to the next. This movie's pretty creepy. So once Mr. Harrigan gets the phone, he ends up passing away. And from there, his phone becomes an outlet for Craig to communicate through to him from beyond the grave. And let's just say Craig does some not so savory things with his requests to Mr. Harrigan. Jaden Martell as Craig is, he's such a young, gifted actor. Like, he played Bill on the It remake, and I just think this kid has a great career ahead of him. And then, of course, we got Donald Sutherland as Mr. Harrigan. And then there is this beautiful contrast between Craig and Mr. Harrigan, where in Mr. Harrigan's elderly years, he is more accepting of death. And Craig being so young, and though he understands it because his mother passed away, he is more confused about how Mr. Harrigan is so at peace. Even though the tragedy of Craig's mother dying left Craig very lonely, he understands that Mr. Harrigan is just as lonely, and they just have this beautiful symmetry between them, where even though they come from two different ends of a lifespan, they acknowledge each other and they grasp each other's loneliness.
Unless they want an answer.
And not to mention Donald Sutherland's performance as being this quizzical and almost protective soul unraveled into this complex vault of secrets and denial and remorse. Like, he just has these facial expressions where it's so subtle but so transcending. Whereas the boy who plays Craig is so full of wonder and curious, and that is almost like translating from maybe him as being a young actor into the role where he is really in search of what Mr. Harrigan is hiding, and it just plays beautifully on the screen. The film is very fleshed out. The cast is well-rounded. I think that it's a good coming-of-age story. It really dwells on grief and curiosity, but in a fine-tuned way. Like, it almost comes across the screen as poetically written on a page of a book. Like, John Lee Hancock did a phenomenal job with the screenplay. It plays out like a novel, in my opinion. And it's more of a horror drama. I wouldn't say it's scary, but it's just one of those bone-chilling movies, in my opinion. Craig goes through this confrontation in his mind of whether or not he's really experienced these ghostly endeavors or if he's just clinging on to grief too much, which I feel like is very powerful. The cinematography is excellent. Such beautiful shots. Like, it's set in New England, one of the most prettiest places around. The score is there. There's no cheap jump scares. It's just a beautiful story. I feel like it's a love letter almost to books and social media and trying to find a blend of accepting our roles in the world without the comfort of media, you know? Like, we don't really need these books to tell us how to feel. We don't need social media to guide us through our days. They're comforting, but at the end of the day, we find our morals and our self-respect within surrounding of people. But for a Stephen King adaptation, it's very well. It's well-provoked, and I thoroughly enjoyed it. What's your favorite Stephen King adaptation? Let me know in the comments below. Check out some of my other videos I have, because they're going to be rolling out. And, you know, I'm going to say it one time. Give me a hell yeah for horror.